Here is a bigger Navi. Wait, what? Don't go anywhere, this MLM.
This 15th to 19th June, whether you're rich or poor, Asus got your back with the latest Nitro 5 now with RGB at only 3799 or 4899 with a lot of free gifts. But if you want something more bangsawan, there's the Predator Triton 500 for 7999 or 899 with even more free gifts. Oh yeah, they're powered by the Intel 10th Gen Core i7 processors. You can even get 300 ringgit cashback if you trade in your grandmother's laptop. So wait for what?
Hello everyone, welcome back to MLM Monday Logins with Michelle, where I share with you all the latest tech news from last week. Whew, it feels like I haven't said that in a long time. I'm finally back at the office already and it is so good to see everyone else. But that doesn't mean the virus is not around, and because there's no readily available vaccination yet, so guys, continue practicing safe hygiene and social distancing, please. Well, we have been patiently waiting months and months for AMD's upcoming big Navi GPUs and its battle against Nvidia and Ampere GPUs. It seems like AMD is not taking any time off and is already preparing for its upcoming even bigger Navi. Wait, what? After going through the code of the newly released macOS Big Sur, hardware leaks found multiple references of the upcoming AMD products, including Navi 22 and 23 in PCIe support, as well as Seizan, the successor to the current 4000 series Renoir APUs. But most interestingly, they also found references to Navi 31, which might be one of the next generation RDNA 3 GPUs that will be coming after Big Navi. Wow, AMD is so hardworking one. We haven't even got the RDNA Big Navi yet. So what is this going to be called? Big Big Navi? Double Big Navi? Or Humongous Navi? I don't know. You guys come up with the most interesting and creative names in the comments down below and I will give you a pat on the shoulder. Virtually, if you did a good job. Nice name, guys. Nice name. We're only halfway through 2020, but I have already heard so much about Qualcomm's But we have already heard so much about Qualcomm's next flagship chip, Snapdragon 875, and apparently it is already in production, ready for phones coming out in the first quarter of 2021. According to recent leaks, Snapdragon 875 will be supporting 100-watt fast charging and also will be mainly marketed for gaming phones with bigger batteries. Wow! This doesn't seem too unrealistic, as Vivo already teased a 120-watt charging system of their own, as well as Xiaomi's 100-watt supercharged turbo tag. I don't play mobile games, but more battery for more TikTok? Why not? But then it seems like it's not all sunshine and rainbow for Qualcomm, because apparently Snapdragon 875 will be priced at 50% more expensive than its predecessor, Snapdragon 865. Now, let's just keep our fingers crossed lah that all the flagship phones next year will not be too expensive. Huawei MatePad Pro 5G is the first tablet in APAC to support SA and NSA networks. If you don't know what SA and NSA mean, then you can check out our Technically episode on 5G after this. The specs remain more or less the same as its current variant, but of course it supports 5G lah. So let's take a quick look at its specs here. To ensure smooth 5G connection, this tablet uses 7nm Kirin 990 5G SoC that reduces power consumption while improving connectivity, as 5G devices demand higher power consumption than 4G devices. By providing 40W super quick charge and 27W wireless quick charge, this tablet has secured itself a significant advantage compared to other tablets in the market. Design-wise, this tablet comes with incredible premium leather texture, which is available in two colors, green and orange. It also utilizes 3D graphite cooling technology that improves performances by 30%. Now, for the price of only 3,299 ringgit, is it a cheap buy? Last Friday, Nintendo brought a brand new summer update to Animal Crossing New Horizons, where it introduces a brand new playing experience for its players. Players can now swim in the water surrounding their island and dive to search for sea creatures like sea slugs, spotted garden eels, and many more. Wow, swimming has been something that all AC players have been talking about, and I'm so glad that they finally brought it to life. Although I don't have Animal Crossing lah, I don't even have Nintendo Switch. This update also brings back Pascal, a character who will pop up to trade recipes for a couple of scallops. These recipes can help you create a collection of pearly mermaid furnitures. I also want to be a mermaid. Nintendo also teased us with another summer update in early August. Now I really want a Nintendo Switch. Anyone wants to sell to me? Familiar? That's right, it is Discord. Discord has been widely used by gamers since it launched in 2015. But recently, it has announced that it is rebranding to become a more general communications platform, meaning you will start to hear non-gamers say "see you on Discord" instead of "see you on Zoom." To bring different communities onto Discord, Discord added several new looks and feels to help new members navigate easily. Some references and terms used in the app can be quite difficult to understand for non-gamers, so they changed that too in order to make non-gamers feel more welcome. And from 10 viewers on Discord Live, where you get to stream your games, they have increased it to 50 viewers. 50 viewers to watch your live game on Discord! Wow. I believe this is a brilliant new direction for Discord because it is already packed with so many features that other general communications platforms might take a while to adapt. I can't think of anything that Discord lacks. Well, can you? If you can, tell me in the comment section down below, okay? And this week's MLM, there is no comments reading. I'm so sorry because we're all back to the office. We're still trying to adjust around and this and that. So I'm gonna end here and go for my next video shoot. I'll see you guys in the next MLM. Bye!